When I'm Coddle Guy, I'm going to be joined again by Wagamama. Welcome back, my good buddy. We got VG Gaming Reborn versus Secret.
Yeah, we got a little bit of a break, but now we're here. We get to start off this Group B, and I'm really excited to see what VG Gaming are going to bring here, and also going up against Team Secret, who I don't think everyone knows exactly what to expect. We did see them play in the qualifiers, of course, qualifying for TI. They went a long way in the open qualifiers, them and EG alike, and had a very impressive performance there, of course.
And then we saw them at the Star Ladder Star Series tournament, and they were all right.
Yeah.
I mean, middle of the road, it kind of felt.
Still got, you know, some stuff to work out.
But hey, we just saw earlier in Group A, EG, kind of that same kind of team like Secret, where you don't know what to expect. You know that these are high caliber players, but what are they going to bring to the table? Where's the team at? Where's their heads at? EG came to play. They look good. They finished today 4-1, along with OG and LGD. We'll see if Secret's going to bring the same kind of A game.
I also think that worth pointing out that both Secret and EG are doing a lot better now than they were at Manila Major. That's, of course, where people were saying, oh, these two teams, we expect so much from them, and they really flopped over there. But they have been finding a lot of strength since then, and practice has probably been very, very hard for these teams. Of course, some people speculated that they were not practicing as hard before the Manila Major, that they got, you know, a little bit rusty from it. Definitely not the case anymore.
No, not one bit. And then for VG Gaming Reborn, most people probably don't know what to expect for them either. They have been bunkered down in China, grinding it out. I mean, you were checking just before this, their Dota buff, they had been grinding
There's
games.
There's a lot of matches. If you check their Dota buff, if you check their recent history, the last 2 months, they've been playing only internally in China.
Yeah.
Manila Major was their latest international games, and they've been playing a lot of games. Let's say it like that. All you can really say.
The last big shining moment that we all know for VG Gaming Reborn was the first season of Star Ladder Star Series, where they ended up taking the whole thing, and they had Mikasa as well as a stand-in for the mid lane. Now Mikasa is back. This time, though, not in the mid lane, in the off lane, if I'm not mistaken. They have End, aka ZYF, back in the mid lane once more.
It's a little bit strange.
No,
is going to be their mid player, and is going to be the carry. It's a little bit strange for VG Gaming now, having two really good mid players. Of course, Mikasa not so individually skilled, but his team fight is so crisp. And maybe it's better having him as an offlaner because of that. He can, if you're really good at taking team fights, that's sort of what you're looking for in an offlaner.
I remember that exactly from that Star Series, too. We were looking
That's where he played Queen.
Yeah, and it's like, mechanically, he's not up to where these new youthful young prodigies are. But man, he knows what's happening in these team fights. He probably was the one at the time to call the shots, and he kept his composure. And you're right, in an off lane, you need that, and he might bring it.
Mikasa actually made me start playing Queen of Pain again and look at how to play it again just because of how he played. And I really want to give him credit for how well he played in that as a stand-in as well. So even though VGR, they are missing Yang here, we'll see how they can perform with him. Of course, definitely not a stranger to the team.
So, as we look at this actual draft, some interesting things to note. VG Gaming Reborn get rid of the Darkseer. He's been banned all freaking day. Drow's been seeing a lot of playtime. Secret, get rid of the Ricky, get rid of the Bat. So, VG Gaming managed to snag up a Shadow Demon in their early picks. Secret opt to skip away from something like an Elder Titan Waga and go right for the Wisp and then immediate Sand King follow-up.
Very curious. And I think the Wisp, maybe Shadow Demon is a good hero against Elder Titan, in fact, since he can save people when they get stomped. Or the fact that he can stay so far away is also a little bit messing with an Elder Titan. So I like this approach, though, the Wisp and the Sand King. Sand King, very strong hero that Na'Vi pioneered a lot and have been running some very successfully.
You can hear it from some of the players out there. I'm not going to try and name any names. And some of them are not too thrilled about the new Illusion Radiance army meta that's kind of approached in some aspects, while on the other flip of the coin, we have the Huskar kind of meta. And obviously, maybe in the early phase, they recognize VG Gaming with a Shadow Demon. You're likely to see the former, the Illusion push, I don't want to say cancer, but, you know, a lot of the grief that comes with it. And Secret maybe just doing some early prep against that. They have now global presence with Io, and Sand King with Caustic is very good at, you know, pushing out and spamming out.
It's also smart by VG Gaming. When they pick up a Shadow Demon early, they grab one of the absolute best heroes to have with it. Just the Luna Illusions are insanely good, since the Glaives just keep bouncing a lot. It's much stronger than having, like, a Draw Ranger.
And then they accompany the gorgeous Luna with Milady Mirana. Mm-hmm. She has been making a serious impact already at this TI. I believe at the end of our first day, or what some may consider day zero wild card, she finished, what, 7-0, 6-0?
She was 7-0 in the early, like, very quickly in the wild card, yeah, which was really impressive. And I believe she has obviously lost games since then, but still a fearsome hero. Just the damage she deals to everyone when she jumps in with the Aghanims. And we've seen some games turn because suddenly Aghanims is done on the support Mirana and everything changes.
Like, I am a huge Earth Spirit fan, and I keep saying to people like Winter, and I'm like, as much as I love Earth Spirit, he's obviously kind of falling out of trend. For, you know, people used to look at him and it's like, oh, but he's the best hero in the game. He's got everything. He's got a stun, he's got a silence, he's got a roll, he's got magnetize, which is amazing. And it's like, but you're seeing all these sleeper heroes like Mirana, Sun, she's got an Ags, and I feel like they just fit the bill, and this particular meta is so much better.
You know what, Call Guy? Just wait for it. People are gonna start picking up on the fact that you can play Morphling, hybrid their spirit, get 6 new stones, and have a super magnetize. And then he'll be back again.
That's when, like, the carpal tunnel really comes in. You got to control 2 heroes with 2 different spell sets. When that day comes and our skill cap is ready, I'm going to be excited.
It's a good thing.
So we gloated a bit about Mirana and how she's had such a successful start at TI. What's her place here with VG Gaming Reborn? We've been seeing her all over the place as support, as a core. Where do you think she's going to end up here?
I think you could run her as a mid just because the enemy now has Chen. It's a hero that's pretty hard to gank even if you get some good creeps. You really need a centaur and the ensnare creep from a troll to kill a Mirana as she just leaps away. Mm-hmm. But you can also obviously run the Shadow Demon Mirana support duo. I just don't really love that. I think it's easier to have a Mirana mid and Shadow Demon is always
going
to be able
to tank. What do
you
mean don't like that? That's the classic peanut butter and jelly combo. You set up the disruption, the arrow's there. But you're right, we don't see that.
They're a combo in that sense, but a lot of people who run the Shadow Demon, they seem to need items on him or he becomes food.
Yeah.
And that's why I dislike it. So if you were supposed to run a Mirana Shadow Demon, Mirana needs Aghanims, there's no doubt. And if Shadow Demon then gets to be the ward bitch, that means he's not going to get his four staff and he will be focused down. And they will not go for that. So Bounty Hunter.
There's a way to get some money in the pocket of Shadow Demon
definitely.
In a situation like that. But no, yeah, you're right. They opt for the Bounty Hunter to be that secondary support now. And as we know, is a very much a pain in the ass for someone like Chen.
Oh, yeah. I wonder if it's going to be FY playing it. FY is a monster on Bounty Hunter. He really knows where to position himself. He was one of the players that started doing the Blink Dagger Bounty Hunter really early when the bouncing Shuriken came in.
Mm-hmm.
And here we go.
There he is again. There he is again.
You know, this is actually Team Secret doing exactly the same thing that Navi did in the Star Series. The Wisp, Chen, Huskar combo. These
now that look
heroes,
at this, this is a Navi draft
this is
without
exactly,
question.
Yeah, this is very, very Navi-esque or Navi-influenced drafting. And I think it's powerful, for sure. And it also aims to break what Luna does. Because late game, Luna sieges high ground so easily with the Shadow Demon clones. And you don't want to head into late game. You just go Huskar, you pick early game oriented, and take the game away from Avicii really early.
Yeah, plus that early game pressure, the coming together right away is something the Bounty Hunter definitely hates.
Yeah.
What about Secret's laning phase, though? When you commit to something like a Wisp and a Chen pairing, is that okay? Is it too greedy? I imagine Chen's going to be in the jungle. Wisp is probably going to be paired with maybe the Huskar, I'd imagine. Mm-hmm. Don't know yet if it's going to be mid or safe lane. Then one of the other lanes ends up without any protection at all. So do they just get someone who could farm on their own and stay safe, or how do they deal with it?
I think that's normally the case when you pick a Chen kind of lineup. You can only really have one support sitting somewhere. Chen is going to be very flexible moving around. Hopefully he can avoid the Bounty Hunter ganks for him, or the Bounty Hunter scouting him out. I think, yeah, you need to pick something that's fairly self-sustaining.
Mm-hmm. We'll have to see what it is here. We have the final set of bans going to be coming out. Vici got rid of that Naga. They now remove Lady Death Prophet. Secret got rid of what could have been a potential late snag of an Elder Titan. That would have been interesting to see. And we'll have to see here what's next in store for Vici Gaming. Still missing kind of that tank, that brute force. We imagine that what could be a potential offlane grab 10 seconds for Mikasa?
Mikasa on the offlane, that's the thing. I'm not really sure what he likes to play on offlane.
Yeah.
We know what Mikasa likes to play normally. When he goes mid, he plays a good Death Prophet. He plays a great queen. You know, I know his hero's there. I think Slaughter here was a great ban because VT Gaming make good work of it and they have a lot of physical damage already. Would also open up the door to Roshan. So probably good getting rid of that.
They gotta adapt a little bit of that NA love, and they get the offlane Enchantress if you're VG Gaming. Then you have a way to get rid of the Gen Creep and pure damage for the Huskar, baby.
Mm-hmm.
I doubt they even consider that as an option. I'm sure it's something they giggle about, though. We go back to Secret. They actually have first dibs here. Who's going to be that self-sustaining farming hero for them? And the other thing is usually it's Envy who plays the Huskar, right?
They could have the Huskar and put him down there,
in fact.
And have Arteezy run a mid-hero that works well with the ganks from Chen. It's possible, but Wisp tethering to a Huskar on mid lane can quite quickly translate into kills as well with a Chen. So I'm not saying the Huskar safe lane is a necessary move. You could definitely have him mid. We'll see here. I'm not quite sure what they want
to
do.
The other crazy play maybe VG Gaming could pull out is, what if you can do a crazy audible throwback to... You get either Bounty or Moron the off lane. Is it too late to sneak in a pesky AA to counter already this heavy sustain lineup of Huskar,
I think so.
Io?
I think you would be a little bit... Sure, you counter the heal, but I think you can't really fit an AA into this as well. If you do, it's a little bit wild.
Yeah.
And it would struggle. It would make their lanes weird. You could do an offlane solo bounty hunter. It's not impossible.
Yeah. TI3 style.
Exactly. Some teams still mix it up like that. It's going to be the axe, in fact.
It's just how much do you put in? My God, they have Huskar with a shit ton of heal behind it. We might need an AA, or we'll play our game and we'll know that we can get past this. And they ran it out with an axe, so the high tempo is there.
Oh, definitely. And a tethered up axe is also just as scary as a tethered up Huskar, the way you can run people down. Luckily, when Bounty Hunter hits level 6, VG Gaming will be able to track speed movement away.
Final snag is going to be a tide for Mikasa here. So they get their own tanky frontliner we were also calling out for VG Gaming. And, well, what's the game plan here? You look at Secret, it seems pretty cut and dry. High tempo, Huskar kind of a game. For now, Arteezy's actually on it, which is something a bit different for them. Mm-hmm. While VG Gaming, a little more disciplined, a little more stagnant at the start. They have to find a way to try to pump the brakes of Secret, and then they can succeed later on, I imagine.
It's the pressure that's going to be on Bounty Hunter to scout out the rotations. If he can slow down Puppy's rotation so he doesn't find kills with his Chen early on, then maybe they can hold on to towers for long enough. And it is going to be FY taking up that job as the Bounty Hunter.
Which he is very good with. I remember last year, TI5 group stages, FY, who was on VG Gaming at the time, mm-hmm. It was a heavy bounty hunter meta, and they were going against EG, and they had to pull out a Treon Protector just to deal with it in that game. He gets a lot of respect on the hero, and Secret should be giving it the same respect here and now. Let's go ahead and get the party started, though, with some quick fire prediction action here. Team with the first tower kill of this game, Waga.
I'm going to go with a team that has Chen, even though Luna is quite good as well.
Yeah. Team with the most Roshan kills.
Huskar feels like it should be. Even though Dire Advantage, I still think Secret's... should be the ones taking the most.
Number of ancient camps stacked by 30.
There's a Luna.
There's a Luna. So I'm going to go with a casual...
6 to 10?
6 to 10.
6 to 10, I think.
I might be over-generous, actually. I'm going to go with 0 to 5 for me, personally.
All right, I've got the 6 to 10.
And finally, to round things out, we have player with the highest total physical damage done to heroes at game end. Physical damage.
Physical, I really feel that Luna should be topping that. But, yeah, because Huskar, a lot of its damage is just magical. And Axe is pure damage spin now. No, I think it should be Luna by far.
All right, I'll put it on the same mark there, and we'll get underway. Doesn't look like too much early fishy business happening at the moment.
Nope.
No on the Mirana, so things look pretty standard there. As mentioned, you know, usually with Secret, it is Envy, I believe, who plays
the
Huskar.
He's been scouted, though. He's standing under a ward and a sentry. He drops that.
He can't get up there and get it. He actually just loses his own sentry, and he's going to have to weasel his way out through the back door. But this is something Secret are obviously going to be keeping in the back of their mind.
He wants to D-ward back at them. He's trying to, but he's...
Pi's going to be close by.
He should be able to.
But they have that sentry. They'll see him pop out now. And he'll get the idea that it is up there.
They do have a dust, but when you're a Wisp and a Chen, you really don't do anything at all. Okay. You've got no damage.
He did end up dropping down the ward. Does that end up?
It blocks.
It does block right in the corner there. I just want to make sure. I was trying to remember the hockey even to kind of make the look there. So he gets his clever little cheeky block, and we'll move on with the rest of his day. We scope out this bottom lane. This was what we were saying was going to have to be that self-sufficient core Waga. Yep. It's Envy and his axe by his lonesome here in the matchup against EYF and DDC. How should this be going?
It shouldn't be going so well for the axe, but I think Secret are still happy though. They got the Sand King versus Tide matchup, which Sand King does really, really well because of the caustic finale. So I think it's fine for them.
Haven't gotten to see a whole lot of Bulba Sand King. That doesn't feel like a Bulba kind of a hero. You know, him for Clock, for Darkseer, obviously, but he's not one to play a lot of Sand King. But I guess in this day and age of Dota, from what we've seen with the success of Na'Vi and many other teams, if you're an offlane player, you might need to have a Sand King under your belt.
It's really quite easy to play in the laning stage. And for taking teamfights later on, Bulba has always been very superb in that regard. So I think he's going to do more than fine.
And he's definitely going to be holding his own for now as he gets that early point into Caustic. The Tide is going to have to, you know, he's going to have a run for his money in that front. Nearby, Bwai continues to stalk Puppy here on his chin, but for everywhere Puppy goes, Pileidai seems to be trailing just kind of casually nearby as a just-in-case kind of a thing. They've made their full approach to the bottom lane, but because they were casually spotted, FY has been pinging them out, so obviously VG are going to be aware of this.
Yeah, and they're going to scout out the rune, and there should maybe be a snag here from FY. Yep. Bottle is not going to get filled up, so that's quite big. Wisp now can't heal his teammate so much.
Yeah, it's going to be a bit awkward here. And he'll just take the meantime.
Oh, top lane! Because it's dead! He underestimated the Caustic Finale. It can go so fast! He walked into a creep wave, and there was a lot of Caustic Finales on the creeps. And it really just takes one mistake like that, and then the Sand King is off.
That's crazy.
Yeah, you cannot underestimate it.
Kind of a matchup like that. And in a matchup, you know, Mikasa, we already know he's not a huge offlane player, and in that kind of matchup we don't play very often, it will catch you by surprise.
Well, it's Mikasa's. Oh, they're going on Puppy, body
he's
blocking
blocked.
Him.
He's
going
to go all the way around the corner. ZYF with one more second for Lucid Peem, not going to be necessary. They will get that Puppy kill, and they even things right back up. Envy considers moving on forward, but SD has a wonderful target in that axe to use disruption on.
Oh, he really does. Yeah, it's great. And this is why a lot of people think about Mikasa as well, that he's a very individually good player when it comes to joining teamfights at the right time and so on, but his mechanical laning skills are just, you know, he underestimated Sand King, and a kill like that is very costly.
And Bulba has been around the block as far as Dota goes. This guy has been part of ancient Dota history, for God's sake. So he'll be definitely privy to the matchup and make the most of it here. He's off to a very hot start. It's only a little over 3 minutes into this one, and he's well past level 5 now. So fantastic start by him, and is going to probably look to kind of enhance this towards a early blink and be an early initiator for his team.
Yeah, most likely.
Definitely fits with the momentum that Secret are trying to harness here in this first game. Arteezy as well, doing fine. 17 CS in the mid lane.
And Chen has been really effectively shut down. He's still level 1, and look at him. He's just trying to get anywhere. FY is actually out-leveling him, level 2 Bounty Hunter now, still stalking him.
This is Puppy, the Waga. He's the best Chen in the world. I'm sure he's been up against quite a few Bounty Hunters in his time.
I'm Swedish. Ake is the best Chen in the world.
Okay. I see ya. Nonetheless, it's something they've probably been, you know, it's definitely going to keep him down quite a bit, but Puppy will live on and just looks to truck towards the next potential place to make work. And now it's this big bird right over here.
Yeah, he's going to have to recover levels a lot right now, so probably not going to gank so much. Meanwhile, though, the Shadow Demon, king with the Mirana for any way to gank Axe.
Yep, he goes for the call here. Now a disruption on himself on accident.
No.
Envy steps back, and that could be a lost opportunity.
Double tap self-cast?
Oh, DDC. Yeah.
I don't think he can self-cast that in any other way. That's unfortunate for him. It's fine. He still has a Clarity, plenty of mana. They'll get him next time.
He was probably Q clicking after the call duration and just hit that Q button too many times. But here he'll have a second chance. Disruption, the arrow will connect. ZYF is there with a Lucid Beam.
Careful for the spins.
Pileidai helps him out with some overcharge. Envy steps in, gets the armor bonus, but is going to be forced to retreat, not going to be able to make it away. They got the Lucid Beam, and they want a follow-up kill for Pileidai. Can they knock him down with a nuke? It's not going to be necessary. They get him with a right click, and VGR pull up and ahead. 3-1.
fight so strong. The Shadow Demon is a very powerful early game support, and Mirana and Luna are also very potent in a tri-lane scenario. That Lunar Blessing makes everyone hit so hard. And he tried to man up there, Eternal Envy, believing, but didn't work.
It is Secret's bottom lane, which is their weaker lane, you know, pairing along with this. Bulba continues to really stride in his top lane, and obviously Arteezy has a free lane to work with. Is this troublesome now for Secret, or is it just a minor hiccup?
I think it's quite troublesome. They are also stacking up their Ancients, so that's going to be one way they can recover with the Axe. But I think it definitely put pressure. As your Chen doesn't have a high enough level, how do you take the tier 1 towers? I expected Secret to take the first one, but I might be wrong in that. Luna might be the first one even.
I also probably misjudged how many stacks are going to be happening in this game. Because you got a Luna and the Axe is something I did not consider.
That's true.
So it's actually Secret really bringing in the stack game right now. Which, speaking of which, FY has casually walked by and spotted out, so this will not go unnoticed.
He just wants to hang around when they kill it.
Arteezy moves in.
Hold the dust. There
breaks
you got him.
His back, then they get the dust. Get over here, you little son of a gun. He does manage to creep down a ward as he dies. Maybe Secret didn't click on him and spot it, so he'll just have that one last little impact.
Yeah, they might have not seen that as he was burning so much.
But just a casual little bounty hunter takedown.
An attempt here at top lane now. Bounty TPing up as well. But they haven't been scouted by any wards. Can they get Bulba?
They're hoping for it here.
Four-man rotation. Is everyone is here.
Oh, yeah. They catch him with Disruption now.
Run, Bulba!
He's as good as dead. The arrow's gonna fly. It will connect. They'll hit him with everything they got. Pilot Dino show up, but the Ravage comes out. And Mikasa says, no, sir. Yeah. That didn't happen. It takes them both down.
That tether was way too optimistic. When the Tide is level 6, you can't go in like that. In fact, he was level 7 even. Even worse of a scenario. He'll just take the freebie. Double kill it is.
Yep, an ambitious attempt at a save there by Secret, and a wonderful move from VG Gaming, recognizing, of course, that Bulba is getting a lot, and if they could prolong his what could have been a very nicely timed Blink Dagger every little bit, that would certainly help their case.
Oh, definitely. But at least Arteezy is smiling a lot over on Secret. He hasn't been pressured much at all, and as a Huskar, that's one of the biggest things. If you don't get shut down in the early game, you can really snowball hard. It's probably one of the biggest snowball heroes in Dota.
Yeah.
So he needs to get his armlet and then start working. Chen now. Guys, double Wild Wings.
Yeah, it's like if the Chen can play a little bit of catch up now that there's a bit of space, I say that, but look who's already on the move in the Secret jungle here.
Yep.
Not looking to give any breathing space at all.
Stopping the farming as well with the Lucent Beam. Not even the creeps are safe at this point.
This is rough because you would love to have Puppy play a little bit of catch up and have his peak in the early game match up with Arteezy, and if both of them could run forward and start shredding through these tier 1s and making an approach towards tier 2s, they would meet the quota they've really been going for. But VG Gaming are really making their own name in the early game.
So, oh, they are. They are.
And, so it's very, very tough for Secret.
And it's nice to see that they're using End on his carry as well. So they're not just bringing in the Mirana, they're rotating very well with the Shadow Demon, realizing how good he is at setting up kills in the early game.
Yeah. So with that, they kind of have a free lane to work with here at the bottom. It looks like top Bulba, happy to move on well past the tower to quickly take out this creep wave so they can add pressure onto that tier 1.
With Ravage cooldown, there's no way to defend that tower. I think you have to go for a trade here as VG. Just push bottom. You have a Luna. Your trade is quite good. They might go mid even for fights.
Yeah, at least they get the Shadow Demon here to start dishing out some early bits of poison. Slow things down a bit. Now moving forward and hoping for a disruption. Not going to be able to get close enough for it.
It's going to be a clean trade then, because now Luna doesn't push bottom, so it's just going to be a tower top going down for Secret. So that was, in fact, really bad for VGR. They hoped that they would get the disruption.
It's taking a bit, though, to get this tower. Secret, without having that big army of Chen and with the Huskar involved, they can't push towers crazy fast.
Envy is trying. Oh, the Ravage is in fact off cooldown now.
Yeah, that's how long it took, is that now VG Gaming Reborn have Ravage up to work with, and they could consider a counter fight. For now, though, they'll at least take the deny and take that money away from Secret. Back at mid lane, NoNo still on the scene defending this tier 2. Arteezy has been here nearly the whole game, with the exception of stepping off to get that quick little bounty kill. He has been firmly planted here, farming up.
Yeah.
And being the head resource maker for Secret right now.
Yeah, that's why we also see him on a top CS. He's not moving from this lane, and now he might want to let Wisp catch up levels or something, as Wisp is only level 4. take mid for a little bit and get that level 6 going. And as Envy finished up, yeah, he's very close to finishing off the Vanguard, so he could just take the Ancients as soon as he does.
Yeah, because when you... I was getting ready to pose the question, like, what is Envy's purpose in this game? It's going to be too far off for him to be the true initiator. I guess Arteezy could just take Reign of Vision initiator by just life-breaking himself into the fight. But if he's not going to be initiator, he needs to bulk up, obviously.
I think they have enough initiation, but the Crimson Guard is going to help block a ton of damage from VGR.
Yeah.
There's so many right legs coming in with the Luna Glaives as well. So that way they can try to just power through the fights instead of just initiating with Axe.
Yeah, he needs to be that utility.
Because you also have Bulba as a tanking, and he's rushing the Blink Dagger. 1600 gold top tower, gonna go down without defense.
Yep, Mikasa helps pick that one up. Got his buckler, and he's only about a couple of hundred gold away from finishing out the Tide Mech. On the other side, Secret now grinding their way through a stack of Ancients here for Envy that helps secure his Vanguard, and as you already mentioned,
oh, it will be
to Crimson Guard.
Will be a Blink Dagger then, I assume. If he didn't finish it before going for this, then yeah, he probably will buy the Blink and go for the double Blink gank maybe. Yep, there it is. So Sanking and Axe can now really hammer down on one lane.
So Bulba gets his Blink, and then do you think that means it's got to be go time for Secret, make the most out of these Blinks, and pretty much take all the momentum back in this game?
I believe so, but right now it's VGR that are making the move, and yeah, there's not much Vision for Secret, so they feel it. Bulba does not want to defend bottom. He's like, no way Nono should be this brave. He has backup.
Yeah, everyone's missing off the map. What's happening here?
They're avoiding them so nicely. Arteezy's running up. They might get caught out, but...
FY creeps in first. Pi's nearby. Has a dust in his wisp pocket. Necessary here.
It's dangerous to go under a tower, though, against Sanking and Chen Heal.
Yeah.
You don't want to dive here if you're a VG.
FY is creeping in from behind on where it looked like the courier was heading back, but it actually changed course to head back up towards Secret here. And it looks like VG Gaming are just going to be running parallel to Secret and no sort of crossing of paths here. Secret just make their move all the way up in the VG Gaming woods, and they kind of read the situation perfectly and just anticipated that VG were on prowl and avoided it.
FY is also trying to read this courier. You see where he's standing? He has the ward watching the mid lane, and he's standing up here. He just wants the courier. He's like, maybe it goes up here, but nope, he's going to miss it.
It takes the low road, and he'll miss that one. But he comes in from behind and has a chance at being able to at least pop a glimpse here of Bulba.
Yep, he got experience, so he should realize that he's there at least.
But it's kind of interesting to see now what VG Gaming do. Obviously, they were happy to go on the offensive, but now that that opportunity is gone,
he walked into
reset?
He's dead.
Oh, they popped a dust. He's in the corner with nowhere to go. Valiantly tries to go for the TP, but Puppy says that's not happening.
Not even stunning.
Comes in from behind, takes off his head.
That's why you want to have sentries and dusts against the bounty hunter, so you might find him like this.
Nice little freebie there for Secret. And VG Gaming Reborn kind of slow their roll as far as going on the offensive, and Secret can now pick up onto their game plan that they originally set out for, basically when they threw together this draft. This is place back where they would want to be, pushing forward.
We're on the Invis. There is a sentry down.
But yeah, Moonlight Shadow, they're looking to make their move. Here's that sentry, and they're on top of it. Envy makes the call. It's only for DDC. That might not be good enough.
Coming in.
Here comes the follow-up Bulba, but the Ravage is there for Mikasa, and that could be good enough to shut them down. Envy eats a lot of the Eclipse. He's going to be going down, but Arteezy is here, and the Flaming Spears fly on out. He quickly makes work for Luna. Front flips forward. Disruption is going to be there to save Mikasa a bit. Arteezy will readjust. Goes for his new target. It's going to be no, and he goes down. Now Mikasa looks to move in, but they can't do anything against this mighty Huskar. Pylite Eye able to keep him alive. Pylite Eye will end up going down, but not before he gets himself a double kill. Him and Bulba both secure it. A 3-for-2 trade, but Arteezy, the last man standing, really, as far as offensive goes. And now
that's
he's moving
exactly
in for 2-2.
Why we see Huskar be respected so much and why so many teams are doing it now. Pretty much every series has a Huskar pick in these best of twos that we have. And it's just a dangerous hero in exactly this stage. 15 minutes into the game, you have someone who can heal him up. If it's Dazzle, if it's Oracle, if it's Chen and Wisp, doesn't really matter. Anything that helps protect him, and he becomes a monster.
What do you do now when the monster has been uncaged and released on the side of Secret?
I think VG have to wait for their cooldowns and then make a smoke play. But before then, they need to really proactively push out the side lanes. They need to just abuse the fact that Mirana can push quite far before she gets caught out. It's a big thing to say, though, against a team with two Blink Daggers and a Wisp Relocate. But it needs to be done.
Yeah, if Mirana's able to kind of at least throw the Ags together, that could help relieve the pressure in the slide lanes and be able to outspam a bit better. But I imagine Secret's game plan is not looking to let up too much here. Could make an advancement towards this bottom tier 1. Then options for Roche become a lot easier.
What you mentioned there is a very big thing. Their next key timing. Oh, they're relocating in.
Yeah, it's for FY. Little bounty hunter takedown, yeah.
The next big thing for VG Gaming is going to be when they have the Aghanims on Mirana, because they can kill the Wisp so quickly that he can't keep the Huskar alive and relocate him out to safety all the time.
Yeah, because that is something they do lack here, is some real good focused burst to be able to deal with the Wisp. Eclipse is obviously not too reliable in that department, and then they just have a couple of casual nukes.
Especially against Chen, right? You can't use Eclipse for that purpose.
Yeah, he just shrugs it off with the Mighty Hand of God, and a mech follow-up is going to be more than enough. Mid lane Mikasa?
Boss TP.
He's out of there, right in the midst of us. You know, what could have been a potential stun or call, but they didn't have anything at the ready.
Yeah, they used both of them and then just realizes this window, gets out safely. But right now, it's a lot of pressure on VGR, even though it's 8 for 8 in kills. And this patch, we have been seeing that a lot. Even if the kills can be quite even or even dead even, it's just not the case of
makes
the game.
Makes it a bit confusing for any newer viewers out there.
Exactly.
It's one of
those
things where it's not based on the score above. It may look tied and close. We look at the net worth, though. It's in the favor of Secret, and with the kind of draft they have together, it's great.
I think the easiest pointer is towers, really.
Yeah.
Look at how many towers have been taken by different teams, and that's going to tell you a big story. So right now, obviously, Secret are doing quite well, taking down 3 towers of the Tier 1s and the Tier 2 tower. But one Tier 1 tower was denied, at least. Small victories for VGR.
Now Secret smoked up, and they're hanging around this Roche pit now. They already have a sentry by the pit
FY down. Again.
Yep, they move in, they pop the dust, and the call's there. They drag FY back into his near demise as he's going to be nuked down quite a bit. Puppy kits it with the shockwave there at the back end coming out from the Seder creep, and now Secret confidently move themselves into the Roche pit if they'd like, but it looks like they have eyes on the bottom.
All these pickoffs that they're getting on FY has been because of good warding. It's just proactive warding by Puppy and, of course, Highlight Eye.
Yep.
And that's what gives them all this control of the map right now. And that's going to be a Tier 2 tower, probably. They might try and take the fight as they have everything ready. Oh, they're reloading.
Reloading, back up and above, looking to go from Mikasa, who has the Ravage.
Oh, ready to go!
Ravage and Eclipse annihilates Pylite Eye and helps set things up for a following pickoff onto Envy, but then Bulba shows up, moves in, gets off the stun, gets off the mighty epicenter, and then the duty brings out sidestep arrow, and Bulba's going to be forced to retreat. It's a good amount of damage, but not going to be good enough. They hit him up with a track, he burrows to the low ground and makes it to Puppy. He's going to help him out with a heal, and then the stun army comes out on the head of FY, who just got back, and now he gets dunked once again, Waga.
Yeah, it turns out to be a good trade in the end for Secret here, and they shouldn't be able to catch anyone else, but that was a little bit of a scary misplay. They failed to bring in Narteezy, the tether. Aladai has to really make sure that he brings that boy.
Yeah, but the great thing for Secret is they end up making a valiant trade. Puppy rotates in, helps out, and now with Ravage and Eclipse on cooldown, this Roche is theirs.
Oh yeah, they're definitely in a great spot right now, and there was a lot of confusion by VGR, in fact. They started TPing out the Mirana at the same time, or TPing out the Luna at the same time as Mirana leapt in. Of course, TP cancel on Luna, but there was a lot of confusion for them. This Tide on top lane. Not care at all.
Split push and Tide. He knows he doesn't have Ravage, so there's really not much he can offer at the moment, and I guess it's just going to be trying to stall Secret as much as possible. They're hitting their prime right now, and moving on forward, and VGR are just going to have to start reaching in their pockets.
This is the danger, though. The relocate is going to come in, and Bulba is just saving his stun.
And cancels. There's a dunk. And will the stun be there? Yes, it will. Tide shrugs it off, but eventually, the fire spears keep flying on through.
Yeah, and he shrugs and he dies. That's a move right there. Sadly, no one can set up for them as they return. Don't really have Luna in a position to fight as she doesn't have ulti.
Yeah, we look at her item progression right now. Already has, of course, the Dragon Lance, but was trying to throw together the next piece of the puzzle, which seems to be an SNY in this case.
I actually think she's going to go for the BKB against the Sand King, respecting that damage, but and also a Life Break. It could be an SNY.
Yeah, I mean, the other thing is if someone else can somehow finagle a pipe on their team, but no one's really at that point. You know, maybe if FY had a bit more gold and was able to bring in a bit more track money, he could be a bit more of a utility bounty hunter, but yeah. They might have to consider getting something to kind of shrug off all that magic damage.
Definitely, because it's so hard for Luna. She needs to go into the center of the team fight, and if she can't do that, then she's really not going to fill her role as a carry. That's why the BKB is so necessary for her.
Here's Darteezy creeping up into the high ground, begins his...
Seen this before.
Siege onto this tier 3. Mikasa with Ravage ready to go. What are the Reborn boys going to do about this one? We'll have to see as Arteezy eats a little bit of damage, but then gets right back into work. He has obviously the Aegis, the extra life, so whatever VG Game Reborn decide to do, they better do it twice on Arteezy.
Definitely, but it's very scary for VGR to go in here, since the Sand King and Axe are both lurking. Can't really overcommit on a Huskar with Aegis, that's going to be a terrible mistake. So if you go, you have to go on the backline, but you don't have a blink on Tide. So maybe they should smoke him around or something if they want to take the fight. Yeah, we'll see. We'll see what they want to do here.
Secret make their new approach. If this fight goes well, they could be walking away with a game one victory here. Arteezy way out in front. They try their best. There's the NB step in with the call. Creates a little bit of space so that Secret can reposition and get all that resource and all that health right back.
I guess it should be pretty easy to arrow the Huskar when he walks up to high ground siege, since he always pretty much walks up on the same spot and he will stand there and hit. Now the Mirana has her Aghanim's completed. This is a big swing, I think. Hopefully the Mirana can have a massive impact with the Ravage next time in a teamfight.
We'll see. No Secret is going to be ready for it. They have a wealth of creeps here to help mitigate the Eclipse as much as possible. There's a mech, there's a Hand of God as the response play for something like the Ravage on top of it here. Already VG Gaming try their best to kind of spam out the wave to slow things down from Secret.
You have to hold high ground, I think, as VGR. You can't engage into them, and in fact, Tide is delaying his blink even more. He's going for the full Greaves here.
Yep,
does not care about the blink dagger for initiation. Let them come to me.
Yeah, it's like, I guess if they're already knocking at the door of our base, he doesn't really need to go out too far to meet up with them.
I guess.
Puts more value in, I guess, cherishing his mana and getting off the free heal and mana to his team. So.
That does have some pressure on Nono now, because he has to land an arrow so they can force the fight. Else, when he wants to go in and take the fight, Secret can just back out. They don't have that good stuns.
Yep.
But they've been pretty on point so far with arrows.
All right, and it looks like Secret will pull off quite a bit of the pressure they had before and just kind of go back to a bit of a reset here. They've obviously gained a lot in the economy department. Looks like Puppy gets his first piece towards an Aghanim's in order. We already know Arteezy has recently completed out what looks like the Halberd. So now you have evasion to deal with, and he has a wonderful disarm just in case he ends up into a squabble with the Luna, let's say. So
man, look at Secret's warding on the Secret Shop here. I guess it really is the Secret Shop by now. 3 Observer wards in the enemy Secret Shop? They wanna see all of this area.
This is like their area now. They wanna make sure that if VG Gaming try to make an approach with some sort of smoke wraparound, they'll see it coming.
I guess so. Oh, they're back at it. High ground sieging.
I mean, long wraparound from FY's Bounty Hunter way back in behind here, but Arteezy's already inside. Makes the commitment for Mikasa. There's gonna be a defensive disruption right now. And the Moonlight Shadow will come out from Nono. But yeah, those backliners from Secret, man, they're waiting. I mean, I guess, you know, maybe FY will try to be there to stop a blink, but...
Oh, they don't want to continue for the... Oh, they saw FY, I think.
Get that bounty hunter! Where the hell is he?
And they want him, but FY, he's been caught out too many times by now. He's like, nope, I'm running this way. He doesn't, in fact, have a TP on bounty, so he has to be a little bit careful about how far he runs right now.
He's way back right now. He's
If they went for Rax right now, he would be in such an awkward position.
But thankfully for him and his team, they have not followed through on moving in for this Rax quite yet. It looks like Secret are making another approach again to the bottom lane. Just as VGR are trying to farm as what they can on the top half of the map, you see how far Nono's moved out. They're frantically grabbing anything out there in the map before the ultimate push comes.
They really are. It's that stressed moment. They're going to smoke up here, in fact, Secret.
This is
trying
very
to go into
different.
Enemy jungle.
Yeah, they're going to try some sort of sneaky play here. They had been pressuring the bottom lane for quite some time. They did leave Pylite Eye down
there. They're showing the wisp at the same time. So they're trying to say, hey, we're down here. Go farm your jungle or something.
No. Keep pushing top.
Exactly.
Keep pushing top. Keep thinking you're safe.
It makes this little move by Wisp makes the Mirana feel really safe.
Oh, man.
And it's not the case.
I'm just farming creeps. Oh, what the hell? Yeah.
They're all here.
You're dead as hell. Secret showed up. Take out the Mirana with an epi too, my god.
Oh, they pinged out where they're gonna come back. Look at them, they're running down for the relocate. Go, go, go.
Go!
They're trying to catch it.
Oh, they found it.
It's just gonna be Pi.
He is back at the base. He did the, what did he do?
He did the Chen send home.
Wonderfully done.
Yep. So
I was like, oh, did he do the TP timing? No, he has
no, because he was there too long.
Yeah.
So I was like, that's not the, but yeah, Chen and Wisp is pretty gimmicky in that regard. Easy to get away.
Not even a freebie like that for Vici Gaming.
Not even Pylite Eye is free. Tough world right now.
You know, it's a cutesy little play by Secret. It definitely brings Nono down a peg. He doesn't seem to be losing too much gold from it, and it's not like Secret able to follow up with an objective.
It's more that they're not gaining stuff at the same time. And Secret, while they don't get that much from killing Nono, Nono is one of the guys that needs farm right now in VGR. He needs that Blink Dagger very badly, and you almost want the buyback as well, so he can take one fight and then buyback come in and just dominate it.
Yeah, for sure.
But right now, I'm looking over to the Huskar. Arteezy has a lot of armor in his items right now. When he gets the armlets popping, and his plate mail is soon to be upgraded as well.
Is he going for an AC?
I believe that he should go AC. He could upgrade the boots as well. Brown boots is kind of sad to have at this moment. He could really do anything he wants at this point.
Ignore my brown booties. It's my spear you must fear. But in the meantime, Secret know they control the vast momentum of this game, pushing closer to 10k in net worth, XP, close to the same here.
Man, Puppy got that Aghanim really quick from when he started it. He's got that dragon flying around now. That's all like no time at all.
You know, I guess, you know, taking out the tier 3 bottom, then getting the tier 2 mid, then the Roche, money adds up, and you know, Chen suddenly flies up from a point booster straight to an Ags, and that makes their sustain that much better.
Really does. I wonder if Bulba is going to go for an Aghanim's, or he kind of has to go BKB here. Against Tide and all the stuff that they have on VGR that could cancel him, BKB is probably the best choice. Aghanim's is fun, though. Works on Illusions as well, the Caustic Finale, so pretty evil against
That's true.
Shadow Demon. That's why it's so good against PL Army, you just destroy it with the Caustic Finale application.
I always like to play things, I like to think more on the safer side. I would have been like, a pipe is cool, you know, you don't want to do too much damage from the Starfall, the double Starfall now, the Ravage, you know, being able to shrug that off could be nice, but...
Meh, who cares about...
I want the cool play.
Who cares about the people who will die from Starfall anyway? It's just Pi and maybe Puppy.
Them get their own pipe.
In fact, they are getting pipe on Envy anyway, so
they'll be
fine on that regard.
Yep.
Because he skipped the Crimson Guard, didn't really want to get that.
Yeah.
Blade Mail and Hood. Probably a better build.
The Blade Mail that looks like a totally different item.
Yeah, that's the only item that changes in the game is Blade Mail on Axe if you have the cosmetic form.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm sure it's not confusing to newer people at all.
Yeah, I wish they did more items like this.
Here comes VGR though, still kind of stuck picking pieces from this bottom lane while Secret have their own advancement down the mid and kind of keeping the pressure there at the more northern part of the base. But they know they've already hit home at VG in this bottom lane where the Raxes are still exposed. So do Secret try to make an approach from elsewhere or
Secret are just waiting for Roche. It's the only thing. Once they get Roche, then they can start making their decisions. But at this time, it's just a waiting game and VG Gaming are pretty happy getting just time. That's all they need as well. Mirana is currently 600 gold away from buyback, and Luna, she's 2,100 gold as well, so she's starting to get closer to that Manta style. But that's kind of the state of things, and sadly, Puppy is really enjoying this as well. He's got that Granite Golem and Dragon, the combo that every Chen player wants when you have Aghanims.
Yeah, I mean, this only gets technically better for Secret, as it's obviously take the majority of this map. You're going to be stuff like, as you mentioned, the Chen with his Ags now building up his dream army. You have Bulba, who's getting on the back end of completing a BKB. The utility on Envy's all coming together. The armor's getting out of control for Arteezy.
He's got the He's got the gold, the ogre now as well. Frost armor. Just adding more.
6 plus 32.
It seems they tried for something mid, but there was a sentry ward just casually waiting. Pilot Eye is on top of that sentry ward game.
Yeah. This is a Moonlight Shadow movement from VG Gaming that's leading really nowhere. They'll flirt around the Roche pit. They could see it's up, but there's already a creep in there waiting from Secret. Just kind of already scouting it out for them.
Yeah, but I think Secret, they're slowing down the game a lot, but they're not going for the pickoffs that they did 5 minutes ago. They kept looking aggressively for something. Right now, VGR are playing pretty much on even fields here with Secret, which I don't think they're in position to be doing. So maybe Secret giving away too much.
Oh, suddenly right to Satanic for Arteezy, it looks like.
Oh, yeah.
On the Huskar.
That's going to make him really hard to kill. 3k HP.
Yummy.
Yeah, that's not what Luna is thinking. It's her job to kill him.
Yeah. So like, why don't you go ahead and disrupt that Huskar for me a bit?
Yeah. But, you know, save that for later.
Oh, man. But you're right. Secret have slowed things down. I mean, they still have some aggressive wards out, but they're...
It's time for Roche right now. They're going to head into it, doing some dewarding as well.
They'll get it. They make their move in and...
They did not find a sneaky ward, though, by FY. See this ward at Roshan?
Oh, just, right behind?
The one, no, below. They have an observer ward.
I like that.
That one is not going to be dewarded, probably, unless Pi commits more. Oh, he doesn't have more.
Without more to commit, Secret just move in and get started.
The gem in the spirits, they found it.
Yeah. Are they actually going to pull out because of that? I guess
Can just kill it and then take Roche, I think. But this is taking a long time. They're trying to kill the ward. At the same time, they're, you know, giving all this space to VG.
They go in. They begin to go to work here. VG Gaming Reborn not looking to deal with that right now. They are frantically, as before, still desperately trying to push out these waves. Puppy not making it any easier. He's actually using those ancient creeps to just slow the roll of this push in the mid lane as much as possible. Nono's looking past that while the rest of his team, as you can see up here in the top lane, make their move towards this tier 2. Looks like they will be able to bring it down, but Secret have got their Aegis, and now they got exactly what they need, the ammunition, to be able to go for the closing blow.
Yep, the high ground siege is going to happen now, and so many items as well. The PKB on the Sand King, the, of course, creeps from the Chen. And yeah, Arteezy is not waiting. He's going right away.
Straight in to see if he can pull off VG Gaming Reborn from their own push. Exposed Raxed. Arteezy goes for the weaker one here.
Yeah, the range Raxed not being defended at all. They're going to glyph it up, though.
Glyph. And arrow will not be there.
I don't think he should glyph that. In fact, the range Raxed, it's going to fall to the slightest poke now anyway, but maybe they're going to go really hard committing as soon as he steps in here.
We'll see Mikasa front and center on his Tide because, well, Waga, he doesn't have a blink, so he's got to be there. The rest of his team look to set up an arrow, not going to be on the mark. Arteezy, long committed dive, puts him behind enemy lines. This might make it a little bit troublesome for Pi if Guy's too far from home, but they still haven't gotten him down.
He's actually got the blink,
though. Holds that first life. Move in, Mikasa shows up suddenly with a blink with a Ravage and tries to make it work for VG Gaming Reborn. The Eclipse is there on the back of a BKB Luna, but Puppy helps out with the heal power, and now the turnaround comes from Secret. Arteezy committing right back in, able to take down DDC. These disruption illusions poking at Arteezy a bit, but not nearly doing enough damage. He goes right back to work on the Racks. VG Gaming are going to be forced to buy out Nono, but it looks like a Racks will be taken here from the hands of Secret. MV deep dive in, spots out N, pulls him back, leads in for the stun, and then leads to an eventual dunk coming out from MV. He's out for the count, no buyback. Or no, he does have a buyback. He actually might just be forced to use it here. This
I think
is going
so
fast.
There's just no one that can kill Arteezy right now, though. They need to make it work somehow with an arrow, and even still, the Chen can maybe send him back if they don't burst him quick enough. And there's Aegis. It's just too many troubles right now.
Nono jumps in with a Star Storm, but quickly gets stunned up. Is going to be leaping back and away here as they try to burst out Bulba. Bulba trying to force out. They're doing everything they can to ignore Arteezy. Go for the rest. Can they get Bulba down? They can't
call.
Get him. The call's there. They pull back FY, but the Prince manages to weasel his way back out. But you can't forget Arteezy. He's there. He finally will drop, but that just brings him back. Rebirth, refreshed, and anew. Hoping Secret can close things out now. RTZ all full life and full mana.
Yeah, the two big cores are dead. It's just supports, and supports did not do well against the Huskar at this stage.
Yeah, that's not a bold claim whatsoever. This is a mighty Huskar, and it doesn't look like Vici Game Reborn are going to be able to do anything to stop him. Secret just moments away from closing out a Game 1 victory.
And we still see so many teams struggle with this. The Huskar pick, even though it's coming as a 4th or 5th pick, it's still catching them by surprise, it seems like. They don't have a lineup that's very prepared for a Huskar, I would say. There's no real hero that deals that much physical damage to a single target. Luna does well, but this...
Yasa moves in, but now quickly eats up a stun and a face full of burning spears. He'll go down, and this seems to be the final hurrah for Vici Game Reborn. There isn't much of a final hurrah. It's already over, Waga. It's Secret who take game number one. With a nice little Huskar game.
Dude, they kick off the Group B with a win. Of course, this is a two-game series. So we're going to see if VGR can turn this around in the second game. Probably going to see a late-game Huskar ban in the second phase.
Yeah, that's where most teams feel like